Hi, I'm Amy Wick from Gretna High School.
When I say regret, you say stop, regret,
stop,
regret,
stop.
And this is my poem. There is a ghost that follows me. She doesn't hurt me or taunt me or even talk to me. She just watches, and I don't know much about her. I would be scared of her, but it's hard when she's your grandmother, someone I never got to meet, someone I didn't even know had existed till I was 15, sitting in the backseat of my aunt's car, squished between my two youngest cousins. I didn't even hear when she was first mentioned. Her name thrown around so carelessly, even though if it was said at the right place and the right time, it would start World War III. Her name, a host of many questions that can still unleash evil. She died of an accidental overdose. She was a ghost to our family before I knew she had once lived. It's sad to think if I wanted to know more about her, I'd have to dive into the dark depths of my family's past, my history washing over me, swallowing me whole, an anglerfish lighting my way, leading me to her, Pandora's box, forgotten at the bottom of the ocean, begging to tell me what she knows. When I found out, I wanted to ask her all these questions, but none of them could be answered. My family has been playing the quiet game, or no one can talk about Charlene. It would make my step-grandmother upset, but I don't think she gets to have those feelings. What about ours? We've been searching for answers, and you know them. I constantly wonder how Charlene would feel knowing she wasn't allowed to be spoken of. Her smile, a foggy morning, obscured and feeling distant. Her laugh, a now empty room once filled with many people. Her personality, a dying flower, becoming less colorful every day. I imagine us meeting, either a park on a warm day or a small coffee shop. Standing before me, I wouldn't be able to get the smile off my face. We would talk about anything and everything. We'd forget that she was forgotten, because for a moment she isn't. She loves my love for the arts and animals. She appreciates my opinion and my ability to be me. Finally getting the meeting I never knew I wanted or needed or had the right to. I'm past the point of being sad about this. Now I'm just outraged. I don't care about the medical records. I want to know the simple things. What was her favorite color? Did Charlene like to let her hair blow in the breeze? What was her worst fear? Did she love music? I long to know where she's buried so I could introduce her to my sister. I pray that I'd gotten to meet her, but praying has done nothing. It hasn't changed the mind of the people holding all the secrets. Wishing on stars has done nothing but waste my breath as I'm shouting at gargantuan orbs light years away. But maybe wishing on the stars isn't such a bad idea. After all, energy cannot be created or destroyed, only transferred, so maybe part of her is out there on the moon watching me and listening to what I have to say. The ghost that is following me is finally laid to rest. She will no longer follow me because she knows I know the truth. She is now a part of everything, and her energy is giving new life to all that is around her. Now I will never be able to miss her. I see her in my dad's smile, the flowers that bloom every spring, and she is the rain falling from the sky, singing me to sleep. I opened Pandora's box and found her. My hope waiting inside for me, every action is for her. The life that was taken away from her too soon gives me the energy I used to never be able to find.